The wait is over. Yes, we're going to do a sneak preview before I do the full build. I'm not sure when I'm going to get to the full build, so we're going to do an unboxing. This will come out in the next few weeks as a full build on the channel, but I want to get you a look at the box right away so you can get your stuff on pre-order. Get this thing ready. I'm going to link down in the description on where you can pick this up. Round 2 model sent this over. It's MPC's 1/25th scale Grumpy's Vega. Bill Grumpy Jenkins and his 1972 Chevy Vega Pro Stocker. Check it out. It's got the gorgeous vintage packaging with the photo on the front so you can know exactly how to paint and detail your ride. We got some nice details here it describes on the side. We got the 350 in it. We got the pad printed hollow slicks. We got the optional different hood scoops on it that are in the box. Let's take a look at everything that's going to be in your production kit when you get it, because that's what this is. So we're going to take a look at stuff before we get to that new tool body. We got that tubbed interior, so you cannot build a stock Vega with it, but that's not why you pick up the Grumpy's Vega kit. And of course, you could build other ones with some aftermarket decals, so you don't have to build just the one in the box, even though that's exactly what I'm going to be building. We have the nice chassis here. The differential is integrated in it, being a simpler kit, but the race cars, the drag cars, and all that matters is really what's on the top. And I love them because it makes for simpler builds and it helps line things up. And I don't have any problem making nice looking models out of simple kits. I like them a little simpler. We got the 350 and transmission on there. We got the cylinder heads, we got a battery, we got oil pans, we got belts and pulleys, we got the firewall. I'm pretty sure with this kit you're going to end up with some additional parts. We've got the intake there, and you do have some options with this one. So let's put some all kinds of plastic out on the table. We got loose parts in the box too that we'll have to take a look at. We got the nice dashboard on there. We got our bucket seats with the racing harnesses molded in. Pretty easy to detail if you've used the paint pens like I've shown before. I'm going to take detailed pictures of the trees at the end of the video as well. We got another firewall there. We've got the hood with racing scoop molded in. We've got parts of headers, side pipes, carburation, radiator supports. On this tree, we've got more headers. We've got some, looks like traction bars with shocks on them. We got the optional hood scoop design. We got another battery. We got a parachute. We've got more engine parts on here. So follow the instructions for how you want to build yours. We got an optional random part here. Tell me what this is, because I haven't looked inside the directions to figure out exactly what every part is. Here we've got more internal parts. We've got carburation. Check out the detail on those carburetors. Look at that. Beautiful. We got that nice high-rise intake on there. Sweet. All kinds of cool dragster parts. Something loose in the box. Manifold there. So we'll show you every little tiny part. We got part of the roll cage part was sitting loose in the box. We got more of the roll cage. Everything seems clean. Nothing has so much flash on it that it's even worth mentioning. We got another belt and pulley system. We got some wheel backs there. We got roll cage parts. You can see where that other little one came from. We got some wheel pins there. Got a look so you can decide. On this one, we've got another hood, an entirely other hood, and other hood scoop options. So make sure you know all those extras are in the box so you can do some customizing. Last white styrene part, of course, is the steering wheel. It's hard to get it down the track without that. Let me switch to the other side. First out, we'll go through the directions. I don't usually do it, but this is a full unboxing, so let's just go ahead and look at them. You can see you can pause on anywhere in here. This one gives a lot of cool tips like they used to in the older directions. You can see the building pattern through here. Very simple build. Shouldn't take you more than a few hours to throw this together with some glue if you build as fast as I do. And then they've got final assemblies. They've got all your hood options described down there. We've got how to put the chassis on, how to put the giant wing on, or the bumper, I mean. We've got our track bars, our wheelie bars. They give you some custom aids. Tells you where to put your decals, how to letter it up. Options for a display, all kinds of cool stuff on there in those directions from MPC. They're always working on those to see if they need improvement. You get 4 tires in the kit, these beautiful Firestone Drag 500s. If you don't want to use them, just flip them around. That's all you need to do. nice and slick. A sanding will make those look spectacular. We've got no-name tires on the front with a nice street tread, exactly what he'd be running down the track like so. We've got two, count them, two nice size chrome trees. We have a steel axle will be in there. I said axle. We got the nice centerline style wheels. We've got our bars back there. We've got our intake system. We got a blower system on this one. So you can see all the options on there. We got just a wheel hanging out on this tree for you. These kits have a history behind them, so there will be extra stuff in them on the trees. We got another set of wheels on this tree. We got the beautiful grill. Will be really easy to blackwash inside there and the bumpers. What else we got in the box? We got a full set of glass front and hatch. We've got side glass. We've got our lights. And we've got a nice single-piece taillight assembly. Leaving those in the bag because I am building this one positively and I don't want to scratch them. And now, round two's extremely impressive decal set. There it is. We'll put my fingers way on the edge. We'll get it in super close. You can freeze frame on that. And then we'll go over each one. We got black pinstripes, white pinstripes. We got the window surrounds. We got numerous versions of Grumpy's toy lettering there and there. We got all kinds of contingency decals. Anything you can think of is going to be on there. We got the windshield decals, the correct ones in white. We got everything you could need to build more than one version of Grumpy's Vega. Very nice decal set on there. So that's all that's going to be in the box. Now there's something on the other side of the box. Check it out. I'll be building this one too, coming soon. USA 1 from Bruce Larson, 74 Pro Stock. That's why we're seeing some extra parts. So that is everything that's in this box. I'm going to do an end picture. I don't usually do that in the build videos, but since this is just an unboxing to get us started, I'm going to put that at the end of the video with a still picture of every piece on the trees so you can see what's coming with it. I will see all of you at the next review. I will link where you can get this on pre-order, and we'll see you at the next video.